Still May 31st here on the West Coast. It hasn't changed over, so I'm still trying here. I'm still trying for a breakthrough today. Can we say that hallucination is a cause? Is it really a cause? Well, you could say, I guess you could say that's what, but existence, you could say it's uncaused. It's a hallucination. It's not there. Are we, the rope and the snake thing, we can say, well, what's causing the snake? Nothing's causing the snake. The snake is not there. We're hallucinating. So we don't want to say that hallucination is a cause, because it's causing us to see something that's not there. Is form space cause? No. Is space space cause? No. It's hallucination too. It's uncaused. It's uncaused. So if we don't look for the cause of it, we realize the cause of it is our own projection, our own hallucination. Only isness is caused by God. It is the God cause, the God isness. Saying that the God isness isn't there, is that a cause? We're causing that to not be there? No, we're not causing it to not be there. We're just hallucinating something else. Something else is there. Oh. Space, space. It's not being caused. So we don't look for the cause of it. We're not trying to determine why, what's causing this? It's causeless. Now the rope snake on the road, the snake is not there, but actually the rope is not there either. But we're going to, for the sake of continuity, we're going to say, oh, I see a rope there. Now we cannot, I cannot be a winner because I cannot be a loser. I cannot be a loser. I can't be a winner because I can't be a loser. How can we say, well, I'm a winner and without admitting there's a category of a loser? I can't be a loser, so how can I be a winner? I can't be a loser. I can't lose being. Being can't be lost. Being cannot be lost. So how can being be won? It's not up for grabs. It's not a trophy up for grabs. I can't lose being. Being can't be lost. Being can't be lost. Now this awareness is arising, and I've seen in dreams, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. Every night I dream is full of enlightenment. It's full of clarification, full of realization, full of knowing. Full, my dreams are like that every night. There are many arising. So it's coming through into some sort of words expression here. I can't be a winner because I can't be a loser. I cannot be a loser. I cannot lose being. Being cannot be lost. Where would it go to be lost? Is this plant lost to space? We're symbolizing the loss of being here so that we can imagine possible to win, be a winner, to be a winner, to win being. Is Is this plant lost? Is a plant, flowers, is whatever, is this lost to being? Is this cushion lost to being? Well, we think so, because there's a cushion and then there's space around it. Everything here seems lost to being. Somehow everything seems separate. It's from separate from other things. There's some, see, space separates it. Or space is separated by things. Things are separated by space. Space is separated by things. I say, oh, space goes to here, then it stops, there's a thing, and then it goes on. But what if we were to say this is space, not form space. This is now space. That we don't delineate the space that surrounds things as space. We seeing something else. We're seeing space. And of course our perception, we're so used to hallucinating this just space, form space, that we're having trouble here getting this, but we'll get it. We'll get it. And we don't see any difference between space and form. We see it as space. Not form space, space. It's as if all of this were like a solid, you know, like a crystal, vast crystalline solid. And we're seeing that, the space. It's all equally solid. Or you could say equally spacious. Space. Let's exchange form space for space. I'm trying. I'm certainly trying here. Just try to delineate space, form, space. There's two different perceptions here. Two different perceptions, space and form space. Form space and space. See, if we take space as being, then all these forms seem to have some sort of separation from being. They're touched by being, surrounded by being, but they don't seem to have the same being as space, right? So it seems like the loss of being is possible. This is all symbolic, what we're seeing, this hallucination. So let's hallucinate differently. Space, 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 space. The shift maybe over to extreme right way of looking at it. Symbolizes non-loss. So even though we can't get it right this instant, we're trying to get it. Trying to get out of that old groove. Space, 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 space. We think we have form punctuated by space. Okay, or rather, space punctuated by form, either way. Now we have space punctuated by space, and space punctuated by space. So primary, we're seeing space as primary, form as secondary. This flower I'm looking at is, it's primarily space, only secondary flower. It's primarily space. Its form is space. Its form is space. Its form is space. All forms are space. There you go. That's the simple shift here, starting to come. You're not looking at form primarily, you're looking at space. You're only seeing space, space, space. Everything we see is space. See, we're used to thinking, oh, I'm seeing forms and space. No, actually, we're seeing only space. See, just space. I can't lose space, can you? Break something in two, it's still just space. You can't add to it, you can't subtract from it. It's like trying to remember a name you've forgotten. It's like, what is that name? I know it's there. I have to dig it out. Just one space. There's just one space. It's not divided up. It's just the subtlest of distinctions there. I just saw, I just said, okay, that's primarily space. It's not primarily form, it's primarily space. Space form. Its fundamental quality is that it's space. It's spaciousness. There's only spaciousness as the fundamental quality of everything. Doesn't matter how heavy something is, how rough it is, how it feels, whatever. The fundamental quality is spaciousness, which is everywhere, equally. See, we're so lost in the difference of spaciousness. We think we've lost the spaciousness, the zero. Zero-dimensional. But take a bottle and move it, multiply it in motion. Does its quality change of spaciousness? Does it change no matter what happens? Does the change of form cause it? The change of spaciousness, to change it all, to compress it or something? Is it? We've lost, we think we've lost awareness of pure spaciousness. Because we're taking space to symbolize spaciousness and then moving things around and forming space, thinking that something has changed, but the spaciousness of all doesn't change. The everywhereness doesn't change. The quality of everywhereness does not change. And we think, wow, we're going to get really tired if we realize this, because then we're going to have to, how much multiplication, how much form do we have to put out to lose pure spaciousness? And the answer is none, because it's impossible. So we will not be tired out, producing all this form. Nothing is primarily form. Everything is primarily spaciousness. So everything is primarily undefined. Primary characteristic of everything is undefined. Because it's primarily pure spaciousness. I guess we can get close to it like this and then relax and feel comfortable. And that's good. That's good enough for now. Have to take steps like this. Okay, well, I did my best effort, but not good enough. Sometimes you have to sleep on it, and hopefully we'll get it in the morning, have it in the morning here. See, form space is different than pure spaciousness. This form seems to occupy a certain amount of space, but it's actually just, there's just one continuum of pure spaciousness. Nothing occupies a location in pure spaciousness. Pure spaciousness doesn't take on a form. It's formless. Pure spaciousness is formless. It doesn't take on a definition. It's all delusion. Deceptive space and form. It's just so I'm sort of seeing it now. Okay, well, that's very great. So it's midnight. It's not that thing, you're joining things, isn't it? They don't need to join anything. Pure spaciousness is a perfect continuum, always. It's seamless. Nothing, no parts to it. Pure spaciousness doesn't end at some form and begin at space surrounding the form. It's not more spacious with space and less spaciousness with a form. Form and space occupy the same perfect oneness of spaciousness. There's absolutely no difference between form and space in terms of pure spaciousness. No difference whatsoever. To think there is to think we've lost the continuum. So we've lost, then we think we can win. If it's possible to lose, we think, oh, it's a great opportunity, now we can win. Do something else, we can make something else, because we've lost this. It's not lost. Perception makes it seem like it's lost. Okay, I'm trying here. Good way to start June, right? Going into June here with a big, big effort. It's not far away, it's not too difficult. Realization is right here. It's so close, we can't see it. It's everywhere, equally. But we're going from object to object to object to object. Okay, how do we fit it together? No fitting together. It's already there. Very great, that's it.